Hey everybody, welcome back to Free America. I promised you that I would talk about buck knives, so I'm going to have to ask you to forgive the sound of my dueling roosters. But so, I have a couple of buck knives, and I have a Chinese-made K-bar copy of a buck 110. We'll talk about that. They're 20 bucks, but we'll look at them. So this one here, this one's, geez, I don't even know how many years old it is, but something that I've had for quite a while. You see, it's got the old style belt sheet with it. You know, this knife has been around a while. It's in pretty good shape. I've managed to keep it pretty clean. I've cleaned it up a little bit. You know, there's, as you can see, there's a couple of places where you can see in my younger days I treated it like it was a hammer. Nonetheless, still going strong, right? This is my current knife. So I've done some mods with this knife. The funny thing is that one of the reasons I bought this K-bar is because it kind of has the mods that I would have done, you know, with my knife anyway. But what I've done with this 110 is put a thumb stud on it. Now, most people put their thumb studs a little bit closer, you know, to this area. But, you know, again, it's personal preference. I don't really like it that way. So what I have done here on the spine is a little bit of jimping, right? Just did that freehand with a Dremel tool. Again, I'm not looking for beauty. And the other thing I've done is put a lanyard hole on it. So I haven't decided whether I'm gonna put a lanyard in it or whether I'm gonna put a brass bail in it. Since I usually use lanyards when I'm chopping, and I don't do a lot of chopping with this knife because it's a lockback, right? And I don't want to bang up my lockback. So but those are the things that I've done with it. Now I've kind of rediscovered this knife and fallen back in love with it. Like I said, I've got this one. I've had it around for a long time. I guess they're pretty much identical. You know, this one's got a lot more use to it. Let me see. This one is a no dot. I don't know what that means. It's got the scallop on the belt sheath, which I also prefer over the new one. But the newer belt sheath doesn't have that scallop. And it rides considerably higher on your belt, right? So they look pretty much the same, but when you see how much lower this one rides on your belt than this one, you know, I kind of prefer the old way. I know that sounds silly, right? But I ran across this knife. I think it was 18 bucks retail plus shipping. So I paid a whopping 20 something dollars for it. It is a K-Bar brand knife, right? Made in China. It has the pocket clip, whatever you want to call it. And like I said, it comes with the lanyard hole. It's kind of small, actually, you know. I like the gray finish. These are, I guess, G10 scales. You know, I mean, hey guys, it's 20 bucks, right? But fit and finish on it is not that great. You know, you can move your clip from one side to the other if that's what you would prefer to do if you're a lefty. It's got this gray coating on it. You know, Not bad. So I carried it, messed around with it a little bit. The one thing that I noticed when I had it clipped into my belt was that every time I reach for it, this little edge right here is sharp. And every time I reached in my pants, I felt that sharp edge, and it kind of pissed me off. So, also the jimping, let's see if you can see that. It's probably 20 lines per inch. But it's not very deep, and it gives you, I don't know, pretty minimal traction, in my opinion, again. But one of the things I am going to do with my buck is add a pocket clip to it. So let me show you. I picked up a pocket clip from this company, MXG Gear. Haven't installed it yet. Doggone it. Almost lost that little screw. Haven't installed it yet because apparently somewhere along the line I have broken my 256 tap, and I gotta wait for a new one. But yeah, my thought is put a clip on it. You know, we'll see. Not quite sure how I want that to look when I'm all done, but I don't know. Yeah, love to hear your opinions. If you have anything positive to say, I know a lot of people say, man, don't mess with that buck knife. What the hell's your problem? So, yeah, I'm going to put that clip on. It's just a matter of time. But, like I said, I wanted to talk about buck knives. I am enamored with this, what is it, 50-plus-year-old technology. Great piece of gear. Don't get me wrong, guys. It's heavy, you know? It's not. No, don't. I did carry this thing every day when I was a teenager. But I don't know. Seems like it's a little bit heavy for everyday carry nowadays. This one, frankly, is not much lighter. The little K-bar. I even hate to call it a K-bar since it's made in China. But whatever. If they put their name on it, that's fine with me. So. Tell me what you think. I enjoy messing around with these buck knives. I got some other knife videos coming up. And God bless America. Thanks for joining me.